The President,
le président,
please be seated.
Mesdames et messieurs, veuillez vous asseoir.
The court is now in session.
Nous reprenons l'audience.
In a moment, we are going
Dans un instant,
to hear the oral
nous allons entendre les plaidoiries.
By the defense counsel, so you may now proceed.
Du conseil de la défense, et nous vous donnons à présent la parole.
Defense counsel Carsewood, Mr.
Conseil de la défense, maître Carsewood, Monsieur le Président.
Your Honours,
Madame et Messieurs les juges.
The trial chambers.
La chambre.
We, the counsel for
nous,
the accused.
Co-avocat. L'accusé Kangek Il alias Duc,
charged with
accusé
crimes
pour
against
crimes
humanity
contre l'humanité
and grave breach
et violation
of Geneva Convention
des conventions de Genève
August,
du 12 août 1949
and the violations
et
of Cambodian
du code
Penal Code
cambodgien
of 1956. As the phrase grave breach of Geneva Conventions of 12 August 1949,
Convention de Genève du 12 août 1949 et violation
Penal Code
du Code pénal cambodgien de 1956.
As it is a long phrase,
il s'agit là d'une expression
very often,
assez longue et
I would like
vais,
to
puisqu'il s'agit d'une phrase assez longue,
to use
je
a short,
vais
a short
utiliser
expression
une version raccourcie de cette
national
phrase,
and international
à savoir grave
from
violation
outset,
du droit national
like
et international.
To address
départ,
to my fellow Cambodians for their information,
la permission
understanding,
de la
and indulgence towards the different councils, since our obligations
mes compatriotes
to defend the accused
et
do not serve the interests and the demand of
Cambodgien,
the fellow Cambodians whose grandparents brothers, sisters, children, relatives,
grands-parents, proches, membres de la famille, enfants qui ont connu sort terrible qui ont péri sous le régime du Cambodgia démocratique.
To us as the defense counsel for the accused, and I would like to humbly share my most condolences
and may the souls
of those victims rest in peace and great happiness.
À toutes les victimes du régime et nous souhaitons que leur âme repose en paix.
After its historical victory of 17 April 1979,
it must have been
the Cambodian people to take control of their country. No more imperialist,
au peuple cambodgien no de
new or old colony, no expansionism to take control over the country on their behalf. This victory,
de, par cette victoire,
the Cambodians hope that
ils
they
ont pu
will
reprendre
live in peace,
le
contrôle
du pays, l'espoir
and freedom.
Était un espoir de paix, d'indépendance, de reconstruction du pays qui, à une époque, fut une civilisation à la culture importante. Nous devons féliciter les victimes et exprimer des vœux d'espoir pour que le sang arrête, pour que le sang des Cambodgiens arrête de couler, pour que la solidarité puisse être encouragé. Cependant, peu de temps après cet événement, ces espoirs se sont révélés vains, puisque le Cambodge s'est transformé en prison. Les Khmer Rouges ont forcé la population des villes à s'installer dans des zones rurales, dans les coopératives. La pratique religieuse était abolie, il n'y avait plus d'école, plus d'économie de marché. Il n'y a plus eu que des travaux forcés, une population affamée, la terreur, la tragédie, la destruction, le meurtre, l'assassinat des frères qui tuaient des frères, des enfants qui tuaient leurs parents, sans pitié. Et ceci est impensable à l'heure du XXe siècle. Et les séquelles de ces crimes demeurent à ce jour.
388 killing sites, including
au Cambodge,
the mass grave,
parmi ces traces, on trouve 388 charniers.
733 in the Kingdom of Cambodia, there were 170 districts,
and in each of those districts, nous avions 170 districts, et chacun de ces districts, dans chacun de ces districts, se trouvent des charniers. Il ne reste plus que des monuments funéraires construits par les survivants. Les centres de sécurité étaient le lieu où les individus étaient écrasés. On en a compté 196, dont S21. Je souhaiterais saisir cette occasion pour dire à la Chambre que les chercheurs n'ont pas réussi à trouver l'intégralité des centres de sécurité dans certaines provinces. On ne peut trouver de rapport d'informations concernant le centre de sécurité du district de Mak Nom comme Kuchun, qui était une prison, et je n'ai pas réussi à trouver d'informations sur la prison située à la montagne de Chokkek. Donc, pendant la période du Kampuchea démocratique, à savoir du 17 avril 1975 jusqu'au 6 janvier 1979, environ 1,7 millions de Cambodgiens ont été assassinés. Au cours de cette période, les Khmer Rouges ont créé des centres de détention, entre parenthèses, des centres de détention qui étaient organisé selon la même structure. Tout d'abord, en termes de procédure, nous avions l'arrestation, puis la détention, suivie de la torture, de l'interrogatoire, enfin, arrivé le moment de l'exécution. Toutes les personnes ont subi le même sort selon le même processus. La chambre de première instance des CETC a arrêté un des cadres Khmer Rouge, M. Kangek Yiv, alias Duk, ancien directeur de S21, pour le traduire en justice. Parmi ces centaines de centres de détention, de prison, S21 était le centre le plus important,
et
c'est là où ont été exécutés un nombre important de personnes, ce qui a amené Kangek Yiv à répondre des crimes reprocher.
Of other prisons,
certaines,
kill much more people
dans certaines
than
des autres centres de détention, de prison, un nombre plus important de personnes
ont péri. Use the same
chaque
torture,
prison utilisait les mêmes méthodes de torture,
and the same
la même méthode d'assassinat, selon les mêmes
why
instructions,
those are
les mêmes
free?
Ordres de Lankar. Pourquoi ces autres directeurs des autres centres de détention sont encore en liberté?
Kang
Ek a lui et lui traduit en justice et il se retrouve dans la situation d'un bouc émissaire. S'agit-il là de la justice
the trial chambers,
et
your
de
honors,
la norme juridique appliquée dans les tribunaux
trial,
cambodgiens, mesdames et messieurs les juges, après avoir
experts,
entendu avec attention les témoins et les experts tout au long de ce procès, après avoir entendu avec attention les observations finales des co-avocats des groupes de parties civiles ainsi que le réquisitoire des procureurs, des coprocureurs, les conseils de la défense souhaitent porter leurs propos sur un certain nombre de points que nous souhaitons présenter à la Chambre et dans un souci de justice. Question de nature juridique. Je souhaiterais, à présent, en liminaire, porter le propos sur les points suivants. Selon la règle 89, la défense souhaite soulever les exceptions relatives à l'extension de l'action publique visée à cette règle. En effet, Duc est accusé en vertu de la loi cambodgienne de, entre guillemets, violation du code pénal cambodgien de 1956 et ce pour avoir commis sous le régime du Cambodgia démocratique des actes d'homicide, articles 501 et 502,
torture,
de torture, article 500, et divers crimes prévus et réprimés par les articles 3 nouveaux, 29 nouveaux et 39 nouveaux de la loi relative à la création des chambres extraordinaires au sein des tribunaux cambodgiens.
For the prosecution of crimes
pour la poursuite
committed
des crimes commis pendant la période du
Cambodgia
démocratique.
The president interrupts.
Le président interrompt.
The president,
le président,
Mr. Castlewood, could you
Maître
please
Castlewood,
repeat the final paragraph?
Le dernier paragraphe.
That paragraph was not communicated.
Dont vous venez de donner lecture, car nous n'avons pas été en mesure d'entendre ce que vous avez dit.
Defined
avant de poursuivre.
And punishable under Article 3.
Prévu et réprimé. Reprend Maître Castlewood par les articles 3 nouveaux, 29 nouveaux et 39 nouveaux de la loi relative à la création des chambres extraordinaires au sein des tribunaux cambodgiens
pour
la poursuite des crimes commis pendant la période du Cambodgia démocratique.
The defense counsels notes
la défense en tant que, conformément à la règle 3 de la loi relative à la création des CETC,
in the court of Cambodia,
je cite,
state that the statute of limitations
les délais de prescription de l'action publique prévus par le Code pénal de 1956 sont
for the crimes
prolongés de 30 ans pour les crimes susvisés qui relèvent de la compétence des chambres extraordinaires.
However,
cependant,
the defense also
la défense observe que l'article 109 du Code pénal cambodgien de 1956 dispose que les, je cite, les délais de prescription de l'action publique sont de 10 ans pour le cas de crime. En conséquence, la défense considère que, en vertu de l'article 109 du Code pénal de 1956, les délais de prescription de l'action publique appliquée pour les crimes perpétrés sous le régime du Cambodge démocratique du 17 avril 75 au 6 janvier
79
ont expiré il y a déjà 15 ans, 9 mois et 14 jours, à la date de l'adoption de la loi sur les CETC, le 27 octobre
2004. 15 years, 9 months, and 14 days. I would like to add
Je souhaiterais
further that
ajouter,
the
en
defense
outre,
file it, its missions
que
to the trial chamber. Please consider our submission in due course. On the other hand,
chambre,
we believe that the elements
lorsque l'heure sera
of
arrivée,
the crime under the national law, Article 500,
selon l'article 500 du Code pénal national, définition de la torture, article 501 et 506 du Code pénal de 1956, définissent les actes d'homicide.
It defined about the crimes
et
against humanity
dans le cadre de, du règlement des CETC, on définit le crime contre l'humanité. Article 5 nouveau,
torture.
On définit l'homicide et la torture.
The offenses
par conséquent, les
and the crimes
ainsi,
against humanity
les crimes, les délits et les crimes contre l'humanité
disposent
d'un même élément se chevauchant qui définissent la torture et l'homicide. Ceci signifie que lorsque l'on traduit en justice une personne pour crime contre l'humanité, on n'a pas besoin de le traduire en justice pour des crimes relevant
therefore,
du droit national.
May it please the court consider
par conséquent, nous invitons
make decision
la Chambre
based on that. In
à,
conclusion,
prendre, à trancher
the defense counsel
sur la base de cet élément.
Can't
par conséquent, la défense
be prosecuted under
fait valoir que
national
M. Kankek-Yew, alias Duc,
any decision
ne soit pas
to
jugé selon
the
la
contrary,
loi cambodgienne. Toute décision s'opposant à ce principe présentera une violation de règles relatives à l'ordonnance de renvoi
of the criminal law because
et
the limitation period
s'agissant de la non-rétroactivité de la loi nationale selon le droit
was expired
la loi
for
de 1956
15 years, 9 months, 14 days.
Le délai a expiré il y a déjà 15 ans, 9 mois et
for
14
reason,
jours.
The defense counsel
pour cette raison,
the trial chamber
la défense
adjudicate and declared
invite
that
la chambre
the
de première instance à
prosecution of the crimes of murder
l'extinction de l'action publique pour les actes d'homicide et de torture tels que visés par les articles 500, 501 et 506 du Code pénal de 1956.
In section B,
je vais à présent aborder la deuxième partie de mon propos. La défense souhaite traiter de la poursuite en justice en vertu du droit international, crime contre l'humanité. La conviction de la défense est que le gouvernement
Socialist Republic of Vietnam,
démocratique et de la République socialiste du Vietnam sont les seuls à être responsables des violences militaires qui ont opposé les forces du Cambodge démocratique et les forces de la République socialiste du Vietnam. Le conflit a eu lieu entre ces deux entités. Par conséquent, ce n'est pas Kang Ek-il qui a initié ce conflit, c'était le Parti communiste du Cambodge et le gouvernement du Cambodge démocratique qui ont pris la décision d'envoyer des soldats vietnamiens et des civils vietnamiens pour être écrasés à S-21. Kang Ek-il, alias Duc, ne disposait pas de l'autorité lui permettant de prendre une telle décision.
La défense recalle ça. Duc has not denied the existence of the armed conflict between
l'existence d'un conflit armé entre le gouvernement du Cambodge démocratique et la République socialiste du Vietnam. S'agissant des dates particulières du début du conflit international entre le Cambodge démocratique et le Vietnam, la défense
rely on the wisdom of the trial chamber.
S'en remet à la sagesse de la chambre.
Would like to address that.
Cependant, la défense souhaite insister sur le fait qu'il existe une incertitude s'agissant de l'existence d'un conflit armé avant la fin de 1977.
The same topics. The defense counsel would like to address that.
En ce qui concerne ce même sujet, la défense souhaite signaler que dans à travers ses entretiens qu'il a menés avec les leaders vietnamiens, Nguyen Chan Dah a pu constater et a par la suite déclaré devant la Chambre qu'en 1977, le gouvernement d'Hanoï n'avait pas l'intention de se lancer dans une guerre, quelle qu'elle soit. Le gouvernement d'Hanoï voulait juste donner un signal aux Khmer Rouges.
It is only
fin de citation. Ce n'est qu'à la fin de 1977 que le gouvernement vietnamien a conclu qu'il ne s'agissait pas là d'un malentendu ou d'un problème
the border
de litige
area
frontalier.
In response to the question
conflit
by
frontalier, reprend l'interprète.
Cartwright,
en réponse à la question posée par Madame la juge Sylvia Cartwright, Nguyen Chan Dah a
the bombardment
aussi confirmé que le bombardement et l'offensive à grande échelle des forces armées vietnamiennes avait déjà eu lieu entre juin et juillet 1978, après la déclaration officielle des ruptures, la rupture diplomatique officielle des relations entre les deux pays à la fin de 1977, le 31 décembre. Cependant, la défense a la conviction que l'accusé
the DK regime
connaissance du
and
conflit
Vietnam,
mais entre le régime du Cambodge démocratique et le Vietnam, seulement après le moment où les où il y a eu rupture des relations diplomatiques, à savoir après le 31 décembre 1977. La défense souhaite faire valoir que, selon le droit international, lié à l'existence d'un conflit armé, et cette connaissance est nécessaire pour satisfaire à et tomber sous le coup de crimes contre l'humanité, de crimes, reprend l'interprète, de guerre, devant les co-juges d'instruction et devant la chambre de première instance. Duke a indiqué qu'il n'avait jamais eu connaissance du conflit frontalier entre le Cambodge démocratique et le Vietnam avant le 31 décembre 1977.
The existence of such conflict
d'un tel conflit
in Mondulkiri in relation to
la zone du Mondulkiri
Brevier line
et s'agissant de la ligne Brevier
was confirmed by Nayan Chanda as existed,
et c'est ce que Nayan Chanda a confirmé.
He also addressed to that conflict was just only an ordinary raiding between the two countries.
Qu'il s'agissait là de
friction
entre les deux pays, mais il ne s'agissait pas là d'un conflit
defined under
armé international tel que défini par
1949.
Les conventions de Genève de 1949.
On top of that, the Defense Council is of the opinion that the speech by Deutsch was very convincing. If you pay attention to the very strict implementation of the CPK's policy, and it is also very convincing that when we talk about the relationship between Cambodia and Vietnam, and furthermore, the statement by Deutsch are very consistent with that of Susti, the witness. At that time, Susti was the register, the person who kept register of the prisoners who entered S21.
Susti
said, in 1976 or 1978, there was none Vietnamese prisoner of war. Only after the armed conflict started that he saw incoming Vietnamese prisoners of war.
Des prisonniers de guerre vietnamiens.
This statement is plausible and is consistent with the prisoners list at S21. They were described as the Vietnamese soldiers at S21. The list was already included in the case file by the OCP, Office of Co-Prosecutors. E68, Annex 28. So the statement proves that it most likely there would have been only two Vietnamese soldiers.
Vietnamiens détenus
who were ever arrested and detained at S21 before the 31st of December 1977. The Defense Council, therefore, having analyzed the confidential policy of the Democratic Cambodia and observed the silence of Cambodia and Vietnam in relation to the hostility and the characteristic of the intensity of the dispute between the two countries at S21 before the 31st of December 1977. The Defense Council submits that the co-prosecutors have failed to prove beyond the reasonable doubt that Deutsch has any knowledge of the armed conflict between the two countries before the 31st of December 1977. Regarding the violations or the grave breaches of the Geneva Convention dated on the 12th of August 1949, the Communist Party of Cambodia was the violator of the convention. It was not Kangkeu alias Deutsch, because he was led, ordered, and instructed by the party. He just obeyed the order.
Il s'est contenté d'obéir à ses ordres.
Concerning the Standing Committee of the Communist Party of Cambodia and the members of this committee, there are still three surviving people now, including Nuon Chia, Yeng Sari, and Kyu Sampan.
And
the government, the people in the government of the DK are also still alive, which includes Yeng Sari, who was the deputy prime minister in charge of foreign affairs. I therefore, or defense therefore, submits that these armed conflict matters should or shall not be concluded in this case file 001, but instead it should be referred to case file 002 instead, which is more appropriate. I would like now to touch upon the responsibility. The agreement between the United Nations and the Royal Government of Cambodia and the law on the establishment of the ECCC. Article 1 of the agreement between the United Nations and the Royal Government of Cambodia, dated 6 June 2003, states that the purpose of the present agreement is to regulate the cooperation between the United Nations and the Royal Government of Cambodia in bringing to trial senior leaders of Democratic Cambodia and those who were most responsible for the crimes and serious violations of Cambodian penal code or penal law, international humanitarian law and custom and international conventions recognized by Cambodia that were committed during the period from the 17th of April 1975 to the 6th of January 1979. According to Article 1 of the Law on the Establishment of the ECCC, dated on the 27th of October 2004, or known as the ECCC Law, states that the purpose of this law is to bring to trial senior leaders of Democratic Cambodia and those who were most responsible for the crimes and serious violations of Cambodian penal law, international humanitarian law, and custom and international conventions recognized by Cambodia that were committed during the period from the 17th of April 1975 to the 6th of January 1979. So I would like to emphasize strongly that the laws to bring to trial those Khmer Rouge leaders are only having the jurisdiction to trial two categories of people, the most responsible or the senior leaders of Democratic Cambodia. So who were the senior leaders of Democratic Cambodia? And if they are identified, then the co-prosecutors should have prosecuted them up.
Il faudrait que les coprocureurs entament des poursuites contre ces différentes personnes.
And the other category of those who are to be on trial was those who were most responsible for the crimes. So those who were most responsible for the crimes have to be punished. Otherwise, the Office of Co-Prosecutor has to terminate the criminal action. But so far, the Office of Co-Prosecutor has failed to fulfill its mission. And on top of that, it even fails to list even one single individual who is classified as the most senior leaders of the Khmer Rouge regime or the most responsible people. So none of them has ever been listed in the list of the co-prosecutors as those who were to be liable for such crimes. So without knowing any name and that the Office of Co-Prosecutor arbitrarily implicating other people as senior leaders or those most responsible people for the crimes, it would not be appropriate. The trial of the senior leaders of the Khmer Rouge. The royal government of Cambodia has three main purposes. First, to find justice for the souls, the dead souls, those who perished during the democratic Cambodia regime and the survivors of the regime. So regarding this first purpose,
pour ce qui est de ce premier objectif,
it is the more than 1 million dead souls, those who perished in more than 196 prisons could only be put to rest if the proceedings are seen to be justly, and that only the people who have been classified in these two categories are being brought on trial. Otherwise, justice will never be done or will never be seen to be done. And on top of that, the position of the government of Cambodia is to maintain security, political stability, and national sovereignty, and that to ensure such crimes will never reoccur on the territory of Cambodia. And number three, that the Khmer sovereign should or shall be respected. I would like now to move to the senior leaders of Democratic Cambodia. Who were actually the senior leaders of Democratic Cambodia? Paragraph 129 at page 54 of the co-investigating judge's closing order, dated 8th August 2008, expressly states that the judicial investigation demonstrated that while Doge was not a senior leader of Democratic Cambodia, therefore, under Articles 1 new and 2 new of the law on the establishment of the ECCC, Doge was not a senior leader of Democratic Cambodia. The following seven persons were the senior leaders of Democratic Cambodia. One, Pol Pot, Party Secretary, Nguyen Chia, First Deputy Party Secretary, Sao Yan, alias Pum, Second Deputy Party Secretary, Ong Chuen, alias Mok, Third Deputy Party Secretary, Ieng Sari, alias Brother One, full tribe member of the Standing Committee, Won Wait, alias Won, candidate member of the Standing Committee, and Son Sen, alias Kyo, candidate member of the Standing Committee. I would like to also address the court that why these seven people were the senior people of the Democratic Cambodia. During the Khmer Rouge regime, it was the party, it was the Standing Committee that was vetted with power to make all decisions. So no other person was allowed to do to make any such decision. So other than these people, no other people at all who were regarded as the senior leaders of the Khmer Rouge regime. So these seven people, if you look carefully, does not list Kang Kek Il among them. And according to the documents by the co-investigating judges and Office of Co-Prosecutor, and that the documents have already been confirmed, that the most senior people of the Democratic Cambodia comprised only these seven people. There's none document whatsoever to prove that Kang Kek Il alias Doge was the senior leaders of the Democratic Cambodia. The Standing Committee, or the senior leader of the Democratic Cambodia, or the Central Committee of the Standing Committee, was the sole mastermind of the crime, and there were only seven of them. And until 1997, and according to the DCCAM documented archive, Castlewood says, until 1977, two additional or three additional people were added, Kai Pok, Ruh Nhum, and another person. However, these three names did not include Kang Kek Il as alias Doge as the senior leader of the Democratic Cambodia. So on what count which was used by the respective chamber to charge Doge as the most senior or the senior leader of the Democratic Cambodia? In relation to the violations of the national and international laws, so who were those who were most responsible for the violations?
La question de savoir qui sont les plus hauts responsables des crimes commis.
Those who were most responsible were classified into two categories and two phases. The first phase starts from the 17th of April 1975 to the 30th of March 1976. So this is the first stage, as I may call. On the 17th of April 1975, when the Khmer Rouge entered Phnom Penh, crimes were committed overtly, with the people being forcibly evacuated and covertly by secretly executing people. These crimes were committed with the explicit objective of enslaving the entire Cambodian population by placing them in cooperatives according to a preconceived plan, as indicated at paragraphs 15 and 16 of the co-prosecutor's final submission dated 18 July 2008, and paragraphs 10 and 11 of the co-investigating judge's closing order dated 8 of August 2008, in which it is expressly indicated that the CPK exercised effective authority
assumer l'autorité
the OCP, the co-prosecutors, confirmed it, and the Office of Co-Investigating Judges also confirmed this statement. It was not Deutsch who made such order.
A donné les ordres.
I would be touching upon who put the order in the future, in the tomorrow session.
Ces ordres demain.
Moreover, paragraph 12 of the co-investigating judge's closing order, dated 8th of August 2008, unequivocally states that politically motivated extrajudicial executions were committed from the outset by military units. So it is very clear that extrajudicial executions were committed from the by the military units, and Deutsch worked in the field of the police. So Deutsch was no way involved in such extrajudicial killing. And not long before and after the 17th of April 1975, military units of each division and local authorities of each zone were placed under the command of the zone secretary and deputy secretary. In other words, they were in the possession of the zone secretary and deputy secretary. So each zone has its owner. So the secretary of the zone has its own military. So if they wish to order any arrest or execution or smash, then they would be ready to do that. The zone whose forces were combined to attack and take control of Phnom Penh were the East Zone with Sao Yan alias Pum as secretary, the Special Zone under Won Wet and Son Sen, the Old Southwest Zone under Ong Chun alias Mok and Chu Chet alias Si, and four, the Old North Zone under Khoi Thuan and Kai Pok. Ruoc Nhiem, the secretary of the Northwest Zone, attacked Battambang alone with his unit. So only Phnom Penh, that was not yet fully conquered, the other zones were already liberated. So these zones were jointly attacking Phnom Penh. But Ruoc Nhiem alone only conducted or led the force to attack Battambang. So all together they worked to attack Phnom Penh, and there were 10 people who were responsible for such attacks. Number 1, Pol Pot, 2, Nuon Chia, Sao Yan, Won Wet, Son Set, Khoi Thuan, Ruoc Nhiem, Chu Chet, Ruoc Nhiem, and Deutsch was not included. So these people, these 10 people, after having control, the power, they started to really implement their criminal plan. They therefore are those who were most responsible for the crimes and serious violations of Cambodian and international law during the period from the 17th of April 1975 to the 30th of March 1976. During the first stage, from the 17th of April 1975 to the 30th of March 1976, Kang Gek-il, alias Deutsch, was not amongst those who were most responsible for the crimes and serious violations of Cambodian and international law. First, from the 17th of April 1975, and after the people were evacuated and executed, the execution were conducted by the military unit, according to the indictment. Deutsch worked in the police section, so he did not work in the military unit, so he was not involved in such execution before the 17. During that time, because as the police, he should have been spared from being prosecuted.
Il n'a donc pas à être poursuivi pour ces faits.
Number two, when people were evacuated out from Phnom Penh to the countryside, people were already executed, but Deutsch was stationed at Om Lang in Bong district. He was not part in the evacuation because he was working there. So it is a kind of misunderstanding to prosecute him on that account. And the secretaries of the zones who were in charge of attacking Phnom Penh and Battam Bong and who were behind the evacuation and the execution of the people were those 10 people, and that Deutsch was not among them. And after the 17th of April 1975 until the 30th of March 1976, Deutsch had been the deputy chairman of S21. The chairman was in Blon, alias Nat. He was the deputy. He was not the one who was most responsible for S21 at that time. So the person who was fully in charge was in Nat. So even we had to call those chiefs of prisons during that period of time, it was far beyond Deutsch's ability to be involved in such crime. So Deutsch was not involved. So the crimes committed from the 17th of April 1975 to the 30th of March 1976, and those who were most responsible for the crimes were those 10 people, as I have already indicated, and it is clear, obviously, that Deutsch is not included. So during the first stage, Deutsch is free from being prosecuted, as he was the deputy chairman of S21, while in Lon was the chairman. I would like now to talk about the second stage, starting from the 30th of March 1976 to the 6th of January 1979. According to paragraph 35, of the co-investigating judge's closing order dated 8th of August 2008, it is acknowledged that the party had clarified the authority to execute.
Qui avait le pouvoir décisionnel pour ce qui concernait
les exécutions. Paragraph 35, the co-investigating judges made it already clear that the party had clarified the framework, the authority to execute. Therefore, who actually had the authority to execute or smash? Those who were vetted with such power were those who were most responsible for the crimes and the violations of both domestic and international law. The party delegated power and rights to this group of people, and I will touch upon how many groups of people who were entitled to smash, to kill, to spare anyone's life during such regime. So let's bear with me to see whether Deutsch is included in the group. If he comes in the group, then I would be very disappointed anyway, but I hope he will not be in that statement.
On ne trouvera pas
according to a central committee decision dated 30th of March 1976, the party or ANCA wasted authority to smash within the outside the ranks in the following four groups of people. I can say that the organization assigned four groups of people to smash within and outside the ranks. So these four groups of people were assigned. Was Deutsch included in the group?
Est-ce que Deutsch figurait parmi ces quatre
first group,
premier groupe.
In the base framework, the zone standing committee
permanent de la zone qui décidait.
This means that the secretary of the zone,
le secrétaire de la zone,
who was the one to make such decision,
celui qui pouvait prendre ce genre
the
de
surrounding
décision.
The center office, the offices surrounding Phnom Penh. The Central Office Committee
ensuite, le bureau central
was the one who made the decision.
Pen.
Within independent sectors,
du central qui
the standing committee,
c'était
it
le
was Pol Pot.
Qui décidait, c'était donc Pol Pot.
The center military,
de l'armée du centre,
the general staff,
c'était l'état-major.
So, please bear with me to the following statement. Whether
donc, suivez bien mon raisonnement.
Or who were included in these four groups of people.
De savoir qui était
so by this decision,
catégories.
The Central Committee expressly vested in the aforementioned four groups of people the authority to smash, to eliminate millions of people within and outside the ranks. So these four groups of persons were therefore those who were most responsible for the crimes and serious violations of Cambodian and international law due to the fact that they were the ones vested with the power of life and death over everyone. And according to this very well deliberate decision by the standing committee,
cette décision du comité permanent du comité central est
the rights,
bien connue,
the power, the authority
has already
was given to the standing committee of the zone. So the standing committee of the zone had the authority to smash anyone within and outside the rank in
du parti
its base framework.
Parti dans le cadre de la
so
zone.
There were seven zones during the period.
Zones
the
le
northeast
pour la
zone,
nord-est,
Ratanakiri, Mundolkiri, and Stengtrang. Mansan, alias Ya, was the secretary and who was the authority to make any decision to smash anyone. So he could spare anyone's life if he would wish to do so. The East Zone, Sao Yan, alias Pum, the zone secretary, had the power to decide on smashing.
Three.
In the southeast zone, including Takao, Kampot, Kampong Spu, Saang, Koh Thom, Leuk Dai, Dong Kao, Kondal, Steng.
Kondal is
Steng. Ong Chun, alias Mok, the secretary, had the power to decide on smashing.
Pour cette zone-là, four, la zone du sud-est, le
zone,
pouvoir de décider la liquidation.
Spu,
pour la zone
Chma,
ouest,
Chnang,
c'était le dénommé Chuchet,
alias
Si,
was the zone secretary,
secrétaire de la zone,
and
qui
had
avait
the power
le droit
to
de
smash.
Décider de la liquidation.
Five, in the northwest zone,
cinquièmement,
Bosat,
dans la
Battambang.
Zone nord-ouest,
during that time,
Battambang
included Thailand and Ban Tien Nien Chie. Rusnim, the in-law
Rusnim,
of
Nguyen Chia, Nguyen Chia était
in charge.
Le secrétaire
six,
de cette zone.
In the central zone, Kampong Thom, Kampong Cham,
there was Kai Pok, c'était le dénommé
Kai Wen, the zone secretary who had the power to decide.
Le secrétaire de la zone qui avait le droit de
seven,
décider la liquidation.
In the new north zone,
sept, pour la nouvelle zone nord,
Preavihir,
Odda Mien Chie, Stung Trang.
It was Kong Cham,
Kong
alias
Sai,
the zone secretary, had the power to decide on
qui avait en conséquence le droit de décider la liquidation.
I would like to also emphasize that after Chu Chet, alias Si, was arrested, Mok
Chuchet, alias Si,
was promoted to be the secretary of the central
zone,
replacing him,
central,
and
à sa place.
later on he was promoted to be the secretary of the Northwest, replacing
Northwest en Yeah. remplacement de Ya.
And later he was promoted to be the North Zone secretary. So he later on became the secretary of four zones.
Par la suite, il est devenu secrétaire de quatre
zones. So those who were most responsible for the crimes,
les principaux responsables des crimes et graves violations
of the national and international
national
law from the 30th of March 1976 to this
6 January 1979
were comprising of these people.
Donc,
and according to the decision of the central
committee,
the power to smash people inside and outside the ranks
was
vested in the central office committee.
Relevé du comité,
so the central office committee had the right to smash people
who
were surrounding the
offices.
So it was Kyo Sampan who decided on smashing, as he was the chairman of the central office committee, also known as Office 870. So Kyo Sampan was among the most responsible people
for the crimes and violations parmi ses principaux responsables, parmi ses hauts dirigeants.
From the 30th of March 1976 until the 6th of January 1979. And according to the same document, under the same central committee decision, authority to smash inside and outside the ranks was delegated to the independent sectors or autonomous zone or sector, which includes Siem Reap, Odamienje,
nous avons ici Preah Wihir
and Kampong Saum or Sihanouk province.
La province
so
de
these sectors are independent.
And
the standing committee
le comité permanent,
with Pol Pot as the secretary, had the authority to smash anyone in these autonomous zones or sectors.
Permanent avait le pouvoir de procéder à la liquidation
and,
dans ces secteurs. Zone indépendante.
At that time, it was Pol Pot who made such decision to smash because the secretary of the sectors were not the full-time member of the standing committee, and without such title, no one was allowed to make such decision. That's why in these autonomous sectors, it was the standing committee that was vested in such a power to smash, and it was Pol Pot among
Pol
the other people who were most responsible for the crimes and violations of national and international law.
For
the fourth group within the army,
quatrième groupe au sein de l'armée.
In the decision by the standing committee on dated 30th of March 1976, the right or the authority was given to smash within the military rank. So it was the general staff who was given such authority, and it is obviously clear that it was Son Sen,
à savoir,
who was
de toute évidence
the most
Son Sen, qui était la personne habilitée à exercer ce droit de liquidation au sein de l'armée centrale.
The other most responsible
et Son Sen
people
compte parmi les principaux responsables des crimes et graves violations du droit national et international.
I would like to also indicate that according to the documents of the Standing Committee meeting dated of the 9th of October 1975 states that, point number two, comrade deputy secretary, party affairs, social affairs, culture, propaganda, and education. So this signifies that besides party affairs, Nun Chir was also responsible for four ministries, namely social affairs, culture, propaganda, and education. So he was responsible for all affairs under these ministries, especially internal
ministère et notamment du travail de purification au sein des ministères. Parce qu'aucun ministre de ces quatre ministères ne faisait partie du comité central. Seuls les membres du comité central pouvaient décider de la liquidation.
Donc Nunchia
était la personne qui était le responsable. Aucun des membres du ministère n'était membre de plein droit du comité central. Il s'agit donc
Who was given the right
Pol
and here referring to this ministry since there was none was member of the standing committee it was Nunchia who was given the authority to smash
and Deutsch was not a member of the center.
So it can be drawn from this conclusion that only the member of the standing committee had the right to smash people. So the question is, was Deutsch
et c'est la question qui se pose au
given such
les membres du comité central disposaient du droit de liquider. Cependant, Kangakiv n'était pas membre du centre du parti. Nunchia a été désigné consécutivement comme secrétaire des zones nord-est et est
after the
à la place des anciens secrétaires qui avaient été arrêtés selon la décision du comité permanent. Donc ne fait
and
donc pas partie de ces catégories.
The two instances mentioned above,
d'après les deux cas mentionnés ci-dessus, Nunchia était chargé de superviser les ministres de ces quatre ministères, exerçant en outre la fonction de chef de deux zones. Cela confirme en outre que Nunchia est un des principaux responsables des crimes et graves violations du droit national et international. Monsieur le Président, pouvons-nous faire une pause à présent?
Le président. Since it is an appropriate time to take an adjournment, then we will take 20-minute adjournment.
Qui aura une durée de 20 minutes. Nous reprendrons les débats à 15 heures.
Sommes-nous
mesdames et messieurs, veuillez vous lever.